While Donald Trump was at Walter Reed over the weekend, he apparently, according to multiple sources, got furious at Mark Meadows for sort of off the record contradicting the doctor and saying that Trump's condition wasn't as good as the doctor had said. He apparently was getting very bored at Walter Reed, didn't like the idea that being there sent the signal that he was weak. And so over the weekend, they did many things to try to reassure his fans that he's just fine, including taking his ride around in a car and possibly infecting his Secret Service with coronavirus, sending out videos of which we're gonna play you a bit. But also making sure that you know he's working, that he is hard at work. So they released photos like this. And there you see the president with a flag. I don't know if he groped this one, but he's got some papers and he's doing some stuff. And then they've got this next photo and you've got him there, shirt off, still working in a different room, lots of papers and things like that. The issue with at least that first photo though, is that when you zoom in as Andrew Feinberg did, it does appear to be a blank piece of paper that he's sharpening his name on, which undercuts the work thing just a little bit, just a bit.
Here I am tampering with ballots in real time. I'm tampering with ballots here, tampering with ballots there. I'm just making the nameplates for the gulags. When I get reelected slash take control, Bill Barr and the Supreme Court hand me the presidency again forever. These are little name tags. Guys, masculinity is a prison and Trump is in a prison right now. I feel bad, not for him getting COVID. I feel bad that he feels like he has to project some kind of competence, strength in this moment. Like,
yeah,
take a load off, bruh. Like you do it every weekend when you go golfing, when you say it is what it is, right? That 200,000 people have died, Americans have died. You don't care about that. Just take a load off. No one's expecting you to do anything right now. We know the left knows you're not doing anything. The right is like, you need to rest. So why? And also, if you're trying to pretend to be president, why are you still so bad at this?
Yeah, how could you, like Trump, even before the presidency and all of that, he ran a company for decades and decades. And he doesn't know how to even pretend to look busy. How do you not know that? How do you not pick that up over the years? I can do it. I've done it. I used to be in class and I'd have my book in class and I'd have Harry Potter inside of it, but it looked like I was reading a physics book. I picked that up and I was a college student. You're like 5 times as old and you don't know how to do it. You just can't make it happen. And so he puts out the, and I agree with you about the masculinity, and man, I pity any right winger that like has the inclination to try to look strong because they have no clue how to do it. There was that Matt Walsh guy, he's one of the other 3 Ben Shapiros or whatever. And he had this long tweet about how guys are using emojis and my dad would have never imagined. What is wrong with you? Jesus, who hurt you? Everybody, I have to assume, everybody hurt you. You clown, and I sent him a clown emoji. I'm sure he loved it. Anyway. So he's signing blank pieces of paper, but here's the thing. It's not just fake because he was only signing his name. So we showed you 2 pictures. We showed you a picture in front of a flag where he's wearing a blue jacket, and we showed you a picture in a different room at a big dining table where he's wearing just the white shirt. Here's the issue with those. If you don't know a lot about photography, you think we snappy snappy. You take off your jacket, we run to the next room, we snappy snappy. They don't know, they think you've been working all week. Here's the thing. Cameras actually embed information about when photos are taken. And if you don't do sufficient processing and all that stuff, people can look at the photo and they know when it was taken. Those 2 photos were taken 10 minutes apart. So what was he antsy? And so he moved from one table to the other? Or is it a little bit more likely that it was staged? That they had him sit at a couple of different places really fast, scribble his name to fool his followers into thinking that he's working? And how weird is that? How bizarre? Just actually work or actually relax. I'm fine with either of those 2 things. You chose the dumbest possible option. Give him a Sudoku. Give him a coloring book, whatever.
Honestly, see, look, again, it's sad because it really takes a village to prop up the idea that Trump is a competent president. It does. And that village is Fox News, it's AM radio, it's all of the places that are difficult to break through to because the people who listen to them have sworn off of any so-called fake news, i.e. actual journalists doing actual reporting, or people who are, you know, looking at the metadata of a photo that was released. And again, the people who released it were not smart enough to erase that metadata to see that they're only taken 10 minutes apart, or that they don't zoom in. And it's not that like Fox or Rush Limbaugh or any of the other nut jobs, even on YouTube, right, don't know that he is lying. It's that they're okay with it. And yeah. I think that's the part that's difficult for me as we sort of move into, we're 29 days away from the election. We're all thinking about how we might actually bring some of the people we know in our lives back from the brink. And we know that they're not watching even CNN or MSNBC, right? Or, you know, they're not even reading, I don't know, AP or Reuters. Reuters is fairly conservative. They're not even really reading the Wall Street Journal. I mean, all of these, like obviously they're not free and on Facebook. So like, why would we read them? And so you think, man, if we could just cut through this, but no one will. It's just that photo wasn't for us, John. That photo was for the followers, true. Like you're saying, just to say, look, isn't our amazing president amazing once again? Everything's fine and amazing.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.